G'day guys, back again. This time I thought we could have a look at this very cool aircraft, the Multi-Purpose Light Fighter FFX7 Core Fighter. Now I know a lot of you are asking the question now, what is Brisbane Model Builder doing with a Gundam? Well, I'll tell you what I'm doing with it. It is 1/35 scale. Now, I don't mind the Gundam stuff, but I'm just not a big fan of the 144 scale or the 160 scale. But 135, you had me at 135 scale. Plus, you also get four figures with it. Four figures, a sci-fi aircraft in 135 scale. Come on, guys. So you get three standing figures. Nice female figure there. And a seated pilot figure. Here's some box art, color variations for the aircraft. I will put some pictures up at the end of a video showing some built-ups of this, because I think sometimes the box art of these sort of Bandai kits, and or not the box art, the actual plastic that you see here, they don't really do a lot of weathering on it. So I thought I'd show a couple of pics that are on the net. But just look at the cockpit here. I mean, this is a pretty nice looking cockpit. Just look at that there. Even if you wanted to, even if you just wanted to kit bash something, this would be a nice starting point for a cockpit. If you look here, you can see just a little bit like an X-wing. It's got the little goggles that come out in front of the pilot's face. And look at this. Look at the detail in here. Alrighty, let's have a look in the box. Let's have a look at the decals first. Now, do you think they've given you enough decals here? I mean, seriously, you could use this on a whole bunch of different sci-fi kits. Let's have a look at this little fella up here. Now, that'd save you a whole lot of painting if you didn't want to do any lighting in this kit. Any fiber optics. A couple little more little control panel decals there. Look at all these different ones here. Mamma mia. How many different models could you use this decal sheet on? As I said before, one, two, three, four figures. And I'll tell you the other great part about this. Three very cool looking helmets. That one there with the visor down. The other two, there's no visor in there, which is nice if you don't want one, especially if you want to use it for another vehicle or kit. But they also give you clear parts for these two helmets. They're actually not exactly clear. That smoke colored plastic, so you can actually see through it, but you're not going to see too much by the time you put it on the helmet with the face, so you probably won't have to go to town painting a face too much. But if you just had that sitting on its own on top of an aircraft or something like that, that's a nice touch. I absolutely love 135 scale stuff when you actually get figures with it, especially sci-fi stuff, because there's just not enough sci-fi figures in 135 scale around. Check out this lady here. What a great pose. She's carrying a helmet at the back and her suit looks pretty nice. You get this little character here. Forgive me all you Gundam fans out there. I have no idea of the names of these people. You get your little air crew person. His helmet also comes with a clear piece. And again, you obviously get this little, this great little seated pilot figure. You can either take this solid helmet off that doesn't have the clear glass in it, and you could obviously put the other helmet on there and leave the smoked plastic glass off so you could actually see a face if you wanted to put a face in there. I'll just go through the instructions very quickly, but as you can see, it's a cool looking little cockpit. I do love my sci-fi stuff when they actually give you a cockpit in something and they give you a nice figure to put in it. A lot of sci-fi kits these days, they're all sort of solid and you don't get a cockpit in them, or they won't give you a figure for it and you've got to try and work out what the hell you're going to do for a figure. I actually first saw this aircraft at a model show, and I actually asked a Gundam shop owner there, you know, what kit it was, and he actually told me it was a scratch built kit. This was a couple of years ago, and so I sort of thought, oh well, that's a shame. And then I was cruising through the internet, and I saw another ship that looked like it, and I sort of tracked it down and realized they actually had a 135 scale kit of this. The thing that really amazed me is that in all the hobby shops around here, they've got a lot of Gundam stuff, which I'm, like I've said, I'm not a huge fan of. But they actually don't have this aircraft. I've never seen it in one of my shops before, or else I would have picked it up. As I said before, I looked around a couple of years ago and couldn't find it anywhere. And got on HobbyLink Japan, and it was back ordered on there. So I sort of tried and tracked it down somewhere else. Yeah, I was really glad to pick this up. Here's a little close-up of the model kit with three of the figures. And I'll just zoom in on the figures down here now. There you can see the female figure. I think she's looking pretty nice there. Pictures here, but I'm guessing they could be going off the cartoon or show. Hopefully the detail will show up there. Probably the worst part about the figures are probably the heads to some degree. They're probably just a little bit lacking in detail. That's probably the worst head there, detail wise, but again, if they're going along the lines of a comic or a cartoon, they're probably just trying to replicate what it is on the cartoon. Here's a girl's head here, but I was contemplating whether I might actually just put a helmet on her. And I'd probably have to just convert the hand a little bit, because the hand actually goes behind her hair. She's sort of brushing her hair back, so if I was going to put a helmet on there, I'd probably have to take her hand off and put a new hand on her left arm. You get a nice smoked coloured canopy. I'll just show you a couple of parts in the kit, guys. Obviously you can check out the internet if you want to have a really good look at the parts. Obviously with these Bandai kits, they all come coloured, but again, I said I'm not a huge Bandai fan, so I'm actually probably going to prime this in a Tamiya primer, and I'll paint it up with my own scheme and markings. There you go, guys. It's just a quick look at the 135 scale Core Fighter, and I've got to say, just for me, this looks like it's going to be a crack of a kit to build. Really looking forward to putting my own colours down on this, and the pilot with the cockpit's already in there for you. There's not really too much kit bashing that you would really need to do, unless you wanted to add some extra weapons and stuff on it. But yeah, not sure if I'll have this displayed with the canopy opened or closed. I think it slides back into here on the actual model as well. Like I said, if you have a look at some of the other reviews or builds on YouTube, you'll see that it does slide back. I don't know if it was common knowledge that this was done in 135 scale. I know a lot of the Gundam guys would know it was done, but for me, like I said, it wasn't in my local hobby shop, so it was only by chance I saw it at a model show and then searched the net. But yeah, 135 scale, four figures, great cockpit, great helmets on the pilot figures, and with clear or solid glass. Yeah, I just think it looks like a nice little kit. Okay, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you later.